Well, Amanda and Brad have joined me at the desk now, and that's because it is time to introduce our music guests for this week. I'm very, very excited about this. It is no mean feat to have been in the music business for 40 years, but that's what Australian band Dragon are celebrating. Here's a bit of a snapshot of their incredible career.
It's a dream run that's now spanned 4 decades. And in that time, Dragon have cemented themselves as one of Australia's favourite rock bands. They've sold millions of records and played thousands of shows. After starting in New Zealand in the early 70s, Dragon's iconic lead singer, Mark Hunter, passed away in 1998. He was just 44. In his place emerged Mark Williams, another of New Zealand's favourite musicians, famously talented in his own right. When it comes to hits, the band has many. Still in Love, April Sun in Cuba, and Are You Old Enough, to name just a few. In 2008, Dragon was inducted into the ARIA Hall of Fame, and this month they'll begin their 40th anniversary tour.
Well, joining us now, no big deal, just a couple of extraordinary rock legends, Mr. Todd Hunter, Mr. Mark Williams. Gentlemen, it's a great pleasure to have you here. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Look, if there was any doubt at all, which I'm sure there isn't, about the timelessness of your music, this anniversary tour just lays that unequivocally to rest. 4 decades in the industry. Can I ask you about your energy levels now? How do they compare to the early years?
We're playing it much harder than when we were 20. We just got more energy.
It's much harder now.
Something happened.
Something happened.
So you're partying harder too still?
No, that's actually
the secret, I think.
The partying's come off.
Yes,
but no, what's changed in that time, in the 4 decades in the industry?
Everything has changed in music in that time. Now we can just take off every day with our guitars and play, and that's it. It's very simple.
Nice.
It's all about the music now, not about the lifestyle.
So obviously 40 years, that's quite a while, like we were saying, to be in the industry. How did you get into it? What was your passion, and when did you know that that's what you wanted to do?
I think it's something it's like a bug that actually attaches itself to you at any age. Usually it happens before you're like 10 years old.
That's right, you're born into it.
You know, something happens.
You just know you're going to spend your life doing music.
Yeah, what happened with me?
You were five years old,
my mother taught me how to play the piano, so I was playing silly little things on piano. By nine years old, I walked out on the veranda, I saw a guitar there, I picked it up and I knew the chords. Kazoom, I went, I love this.
It was ordained.
Kazoom.
Away you go. Can I just say, as all Dragon fans like us, you are doing such a wonderful job, but of course, such a big part of Dragon is Mark Hunter. And the early days, Todd, how did you find it being out there without your brother?
Well, there was no band for 10 years after Mark went, and there never was going to be. And in the end, it just felt like these songs should be played again. So I got these guys together and away we went. We've done 500 shows since then. So early on, it was nerve-wracking, but you'd get out there and you'd play your first song and the whole crowd would just relax into the songs. So they're not our songs, they belong to everybody, we're just playing them.
Talking of everybody, Ange Bishop was telling me last night, when they had the fundraisers when Mark was ill in Sydney and Melbourne, so many great Australian performers got up and sang Dragon songs. And Dragon songs lend themselves to all performers, don't they?
They work if you're walking past on a beach and people are singing them, or in a pub or whatever.
Yeah.
It's great, we're very lucky.
Anybody can sing them.
They're great songs.
They're just great to sing. The songs are just great.
Do you still enjoy singing them as much as you did in those early years? You know, you're talking back to the 70s for April Sun in Cuba, which you'll play for us a little bit earlier.
A little bit later, rather.
You still enjoy the process of playing those songs as much?
Yeah, I did. The joy in the songs will never die.
It's a thrilling thing to be a working band where you just go out and play.
Do you still have to pinch yourself sometimes to think 40 years, like this is where you are now? Do you look back at it and think, wow, how far you've come?
The audience is younger. That's what we found.
Every decade you play to a completely different set of people.
Talking of younger, can I just say very quickly, we nearly had Civil War in the late news team.
We've been arguing all day.
I know you're playing April Sun in Cuba. I and Sally, our EP, we wanted Young Years. Can you maybe hang around in sport? I know you're sports fans, and maybe you could play us after the next break. You could play us Young Years.
Love to.
You can do that.
We would be absolutely delighted, gentlemen. And just finally, before you guys, well, we've been arguing with some New Zealand colleagues today. Of course, you formed in 73 in New Zealand. You're here in Australia a couple of years later. That means we can claim you. Australia's the heartland, isn't it?
The heartland.
Excellent.
Dare we say.
I needed to get that confession before we could move on. Wonderful. That's a big tick. We'll chat to you very shortly, gentlemen. Thank you very much. It is time for sport now with Brad.
Yeah, I've had a win there. Young Years coming up in a moment after the break.
All right, well, the gentlemen from Dragon have been very, very patiently hanging around, Todd Hunter and Mark Williams. You're going to be kind enough. We've been arguing about whether or not we're going to hear from April Sun in Cuba a little bit later. Yeah. You're going to throw us out to the break with a bit of Young Years.
Especially for you, Brad.
For me, thank you.
Especially for Brad. Those were our young.